gone for a while, but I ain't throw the towel. Got the cake on me now, I get paid off the vow. Stay way up in the cloud.
Lil Tecca. After first really blowing up back in 2019, Lil Tecca hadn't been seeing too much growth and success in the past year or so. Following his debut mixtape, We Love You Tecca, which dropped back in August of 2019, he would drop a few more singles before then releasing his debut album in the fall of 2020. That debut album, Virgo World, would go on to sell 35K in its first week. And if you ask me, as well as a lot of other people as well, I didn't think that album was very good. And then it just seemed like for a while there, a lot of people just kind of lost interest in Lil Tecca and his music, and it really looked like he was going to fall off. However, for a couple reasons I'm about to get into in this video, lately he's been able to get some of that attention back on him and get people back to listening to his music again. So in this video, I'm going to discuss the Lil Tecca comeback.
What if you left here and you could dip and do anything you wanted to do fun? What would it be?
I go to sleep.
So as I mentioned, Lil Tecca first really blew up back in 2019 thanks to his first huge hit single, Ransom, which along with a Cole Bennett and Lyrical Lemonade video, would put more eyes on Tecca than he'd ever had before.
A compelling artist plus an internet money beat plus a Cole Bennett video, is that a hit?
Yeah. 100%.
And that Internet Money produced track would go on to peak at number 4 on the Billboard Hot 100 chart, and would introduce the world to this 16-year-old kid with glasses and braces, whose flows and melodies on there would help give him one of the biggest songs of the year. So then to capitalize on all of the hype he had going for him, Tecca would drop his debut mixtape, We Love You Tecca, which I would say is his best project yet. But that's also not saying too much, as his only other project is again his debut album, Virgo World. And besides a few select songs I enjoy off of it, which are mainly because of the features, again, I thought that album was very weak. A lot of the tracks were just boring to me, and didn't really do anything to stand out or make them memorable in any way. So then following that disappointing debut album, it seemed like a lot of people just kind of stopped caring about Tecca and his music. And in a time when there are so many other artists putting out music, and a lot of them in that same melodic trap lane as Tecca, as he himself would even tweet, "There's like 30 other rappers that sound just like me," it's easy to see why people moved on from him after this project full of generic trap beats and lazy repetitive flows. But Tecca would then go on to drop a few more singles, which again, I thought were mostly boring and none of them really gained any traction either. So at this point, it really seemed like Lil Tecca was about to fall off, and would go down as just being remembered as the guy who made Ransom, at least in the mainstream. I will say that Tecca has always had a pretty strong fan base that supports him, but in terms of hits or any songs that people outside of his dedicated fans would listen to, it wasn't looking so good. However, in the past few months, Lil Tecca has actually been able to get attention back on him and his music. I think the biggest reason why is due to his three most recent singles he's put out. The first one, titled Never Left, dropped back in May of this year, and would actually be his first solo track to chart in the US since his debut mixtape in 2019. With a lot of people labeling it as Tecca's comeback hit, this song would do much better numbers than any of the other singles he had been putting out, and would also get some help from it blowing up on TikTok. So then he would drop his next single at the end of July, titled Money On Me, and would also come out with another Cole Bennett video as well. And personally, this is my favorite of the three recent singles, and definitely the one I've played the most. I think it just really showcases what Lil Tecca does best. His tracks are never super deep or lyrical, but just fun, catchy music that's chill to vibe out to or throw on at parties. So then following Money On Me, Lil Tecca actually announced that his new album, We Love You Tecca 2, would be dropping on August 6th. However, as we saw, Tecca would claim that the album was being pushed back due to a clearance issue. But really, I think it was just because that was the day Kanye was supposed to drop Donda, which as we also saw, didn't happen either. So instead of dropping his new album on August 6th, Lil Tecca would instead put out another single, this one titled Repeat It, and also featured Gunna on it as well. And again, I thought this one was also pretty fire, and it would also chart as well as receive some good playlisting from both Spotify and Apple Music. So now after these three solid singles, it seems like a lot of people, including myself, are actually looking forward to this new album from Lil Tecca. But along with actually getting back to putting out good music, Lil Tecca has also been making moves as a producer.
Because I can make the most raw-ish sounding beat, and I won't care if the nigga says it's trash or none of that, because when it comes to my beats, like, I see my freedom a lot.
Tecca would actually make the beat for So Fago's biggest track to date, Knock Knock, as well as a few other beats for underground artists as well. And he also self-produced one of his 2020 singles, IDK, which would also get a Cole Bennett video too. So along with all of that, Lil Tecca has also appeared a few times on Aiden Ross's streams, which is a great way to get some attention these days, as well as been back performing at shows and festivals. And with this new album on the way, which again I'm actually excited to listen to, Lil Tecca has been able to make a pretty solid comeback in the past few months. Now this new album has to be pretty good too, or then people will really turn away from him again, but after hearing these three recent singles, which I would guess will all be on it, as well as him naming it as the sequel to his most popular project, I have high hopes for this new album. So that'll do it for this video on Lil Tecca. If you haven't yet, please do me a favor and drop a like for me. And also be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay tuned for new videos every week. I also wanted to mention that I finally started an Instagram page for the channel, so be sure to also check that out as well.
Gone for a while, but I ain't throw the towel. Got the cake on me now, I get paid off the amount. Stay way up in the cloud, looking over the crowd. Got the bag and it's loud, ain't no weak shit allowed. I was gone for a while, but I ain't.